To help carry on our important work, I want you to join the Secret Squadron and wear this official badge and have this secret decoder.
Hi everyone, my name is Serife Tekin. I'm an associate professor at the University of Texas at San Antonio. And I'm currently visiting the Center for Philosophy of Science at the University of Pittsburgh as a visiting fellow. I will tell you a little bit about my research today. My work is in philosophy of psychiatry, and it takes place at the cusp of philosophy of science, philosophy of mind, and bioethics. My fundamental goal is to understand and explain the relationship between the concept of the self and the concept of mental disorder. I approach this topic from a variety of angles, and I have basically three leading questions that I try to develop answers to. So my first question is, do the contemporary scientific approaches to mental disorders explain successfully how mental disorders are experienced by individuals or patients? So to achieve this goal, I look at contemporary scientific work. This includes the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, the categorization of mental disorders. The DSM categorizes mental disorders according to symptoms and signs. That's one framework. I also look at more recent approaches to mental disorders, such as the research domain criteria, as well as recent work in artificial intelligence that aims to unpack what mental disorders are and how they're experienced. My observation in all these lines of scientific approaches to mental disorders is that they fall short. They fall short because they do not take the complexity of the subject who encounters mental disorders. And this becomes evident when I turn to first-person accounts of people who have written about their mental disorders. There's a gap. And one of the reasons that such gap exists is that in a lot of these scientific frameworks, the goal is to arrive at generalizable features of mental disorders so that we can develop like these systematic and scientific approaches. So there's this assumption that if we engage with subjective or self-related details, we wouldn't be doing science. So I challenge this assumption. I argue that it is possible to engage with self-related and particular dimensions of experience with mental disorder in a way that also allows us to do science and draw generalizations. So for that purpose, I develop a model of the self that I call the multitudinous self to better express, better reflect the complexity of encounter with mental disorder in relation to the self. And that kind of takes me to the second thread of my work, which is in philosophy of mind and cognitive science, where I utilize conceptions of the self in philosophy and cognitive sciences in developing the model of the self, the multitudinous self, that also gives us a better picture of mental disorders. And all of these critical and constructive dimensions of my work kind of come to fruition when I turn to ethics or bioethics and ask the question, what can we do, or what can be done to help individuals with mental disorders to flourish? So flourishing is not the same as treatment or fixing the person. That's something else, right? And unfortunately, in contemporary conversations about mental disorders in scientific and clinical contexts, this possibility of an individual flourishing, withstanding their encounter with mental disorder, has not been explored. And my model of the self, the multitudinous self, promises to develop resources and tools in which we can imagine individuals with mental disorders flourishing. essential to my work methodology is direct engagement with the first person reports of individuals with mental disorders. And for that, I turn to feminist philosophy and feminist philosophy of science to make that project attainable and possible.